Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you the pencil trick to quickly and easily identify primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary, carbon, and other atoms. Let's start with carbon atoms. When you're looking at a molecule, if you see a carbon atom bound to other atoms, the way you classify this carbon is by looking at how many carbons are attached to it. In the first example, I give you methane. It doesn't have any carbons attached, so it wouldn't fall under this classification. But if I take this carbon, remove one hydrogen atom, and swap that for a CH3, this carbon is now considered a primary carbon atom because it's attached to one other carbon atom. If I remove two hydrogen atoms and replace them with other carbons, for example, methyl groups, the central carbon now being attached to two other carbon atoms is considered a secondary carbon. If I swap three hydrogens for carbon, in this case methyl, the central atom is now attached to one, two, three carbon atoms, making it a tertiary carbon. And last but not least, if I swap each of the hydrogens for a carbon atom, in this case four methyls, that central carbon is attached to one, two, three, four carbon atoms, making it a quaternary carbon. This is the simple approach, but what happens if the molecule you see is not drawn in Lewis structure? What if you're not shown a Lewis structure where all the carbons are visible? What if you have to figure this out in line structure? Do you draw it out so that you can clearly see what's going on? Absolutely not. This is where we introduce the pencil trick, and this is how it works. Imagine that my stylus is the pencil, and you put it down on a carbon atom. What you want to do is look at that pencil point and see what is coming out of that pencil point. Specifically, we're looking for bonds to carbon atoms. If I want to know the substitution of this carbon here, all I do is put down my pencil and look at how many lines come directly from that point. Right now I see one, two, three. Three lines coming out of it means three carbons attached, making this a tertiary carbon. What about this one right here? I only have one line coming out of my pencil tip, making it primary. You'll notice that all terminal carbons are going to be primary. So anytime you see the end of a chain, knowing that this works once, it'll always work. These are all primary carbons. What about this one right here? From my pencil tip, I see one, two, making that a secondary carbon atom. This trick works anytime you need to classify carbon atoms, not just in a standard boring chain. For example, say you have a molecule with a carbocation, and you're trying to determine which carbocation is more stable. What do we know about carbocation stability? The more substituted, the more stable, as explained in the video link below. So how do we figure this out? Put your pencil down. We have two bonds coming out of it. This right here is a secondary carbocation. On the right, put your pencil down, one line coming out of it. This is a primary carbocation. Same trick applies to radicals. The molecule on the left has a radical at the end. If we put the pencil down, one line, one bond to carbon, making this a primary radical. And the molecule on the right, when you put the pencil down, has two lines coming out of it, meaning two bonds to carbon, making it a secondary radical. When it comes to an atom attached to carbon, we look at it slightly differently. We're still looking at the carbon atom, but specifically the carbon holding that atom in question. Say I asked you how many primary hydrogens we have on this molecule. We can't look for the bonds coming from hydrogen to carbon because, as you know, hydrogen can only form one bond, and in this case, it'll be one bond between carbon and hydrogen. Instead, we're looking for the number of primary carbons and then figuring out how many hydrogens are on them. What we need is to find which carbon atom has just one line coming out of it to make it a primary carbon atom, and that gives us a total of three, then figure out how many hydrogens sit on this carbon. The trick to figure this out is four, being the total number of bonds you can have on carbon, minus all of the visible bonds, because these are visible to other atoms like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. The rest will be hydrogen atoms. For this carbon, we see one bond, 4 minus 1 equals 3, and we can prove it by drawing it in. Now, I'm only drawing this to show you, but on exams, you never, ever, ever want to waste time drawing in hydrogen atoms. Carbon below, same thing, 4 minus 1 is 3, and carbon on the left, 4 minus 1 is 3. We have 3 primary carbons, each containing 3 hydrogens, for a total of 9 primary hydrogen atoms. For secondary hydrogens, we're looking for secondary carbons, which when you put the pencil down has 2 lines coming out of it and we have just 1. But how many hydrogens sit on that carbon? If we have 4 bonds, we have 4 possible bonds minus the 2 visible to carbon equals 2 hydrogen atoms on a secondary carbon, and we have 1 secondary carbon, which gives us 2 secondary hydrogens. For tertiary hydrogen, we're looking for a tertiary carbon. That's carbon with 3 lines coming out of my pencil tip, and we have 1 of them. Carbon can have 4 bonds, minus 3 bonds to carbon is 1 remaining for hydrogen, which means 1 tertiary carbon having 1 hydrogen atom gives us a total of 1 tertiary hydrogen. We can't have quaternary hydrogen, because if carbon can have a max of 4 bonds, and those are all bonds to carbon, we have nowhere left for the hydrogen. Same thing works for alcohol. We're looking at the degree of substitution of the carbon atom specifically that is holding your alcohol. For example, if I give you methanol, methanol would not be considered a substituted alcohol because the carbon that is holding the oxygen is not bound to any other carbon atoms. If I put my pencil down, I have no lines to carbon. That means it's not substituted at all. If we look at ethanol, the alcohol is attached to this carbon. There is 1 line to another carbon. Remember, it's a line to carbon. We do not count the line to oxygen because we're looking specifically at the carbon holding the oxygen. How many carbons is that attached to? Ethanol would be a primary alcohol. If we look at isopropyl alcohol, the central carbon is holding on to the oxygen, but it's also got 2 lines coming out to carbon atoms, making this a secondary alcohol. Tert-butanol, or tertiary butyl alcohol, has 3 lines coming out of my pencil tip, making this a tertiary alcohol. What if I want a quaternary alcohol? Can I do that? I would attempt to draw the molecule backwards. I would start with my carbon atom, with my pencil point, attempt to draw 4 bonds to carbon, but then I can't put in an alcohol because that oxygen is bound to a carbon that already has 4 bonds. That means we have 5 bonds to carbon, which is not allowed. It violates the octet. So we have to stop at tertiary alcohols. Alkyl halides are classified the same way. Say I have a molecule with multiple chlorine atoms, and I want to identify the degree of substitution of each one. We'll start with the purple chlorine on the right. Putting the pencil down, I have just 1 line, 1 bond to carbon, making it a primary halogen, or a primary alkyl halide. The green chlorine sits on a carbon that has 3 lines coming out of it, 3 bonds to carbon, making it a tertiary chloride, or a tertiary alkyl halide. Finally, the blue chlorine sits on a carbon that has 2 lines, 2 bonds to carbon coming out of it, making it a secondary chloride. The last type of molecule I want to look at are substituted amines. Say I give you a molecule that looks like this. We have a CH3 bound to a nitrogen, bound to an isopropyl group. When looking at the carbon holding the nitrogen, am I using the one on the left? Or am I using the one on the right? The answer is both and neither. Amines are different. We're not looking at the substitution of the carbon holding the nitrogen. Instead, we're looking at the number of carbon atoms coming out of nitrogen. That means the pencil trick applies to the nitrogen directly, and this would be considered a secondary amine, not because the carbon is bound to 2 carbons, but because the nitrogen is bound to 2 carbons. So let's classify amines, starting with ammonia. Ammonia is not an amine because it's not bound to any carbon atoms. Remember, the amine functional group is an R bound to an N, where R can be any sort of carbon chain. The simplest amine would be a nitrogen bound to two hydrogen atoms and one carbon, for example, a CH3. This nitrogen is bound to one carbon, making it a primary amine. If I remove two hydrogens and swap them for R groups, for example, two methyls, the nitrogen, when you put your pencil down on nitrogen, you get two lines coming out of it towards carbon. Nitrogen is bound to two R groups, making this a secondary amine. If I replace all three hydrogen atoms with carbon, when I put my pencil down, I get one, two, three lines coming out of nitrogen to give me a tertiary amine. And that's it. That's all the hydrogen atoms to replace. But that doesn't mean I stop there. Remember, ammonia could be a base, and the lone pairs can grab a hydrogen, which means if I swap all three hydrogen atoms and the lone pair for an R group, for example, four methyls, first thing I have to remember is the formal charge. Should minus has, as taught in the video link below, in this case would be 4 minus 3, which is equal to plus 1. This would be a quaternary amine, which is actually called an ammonium, where the IUM reminds you that it has a positive charge on the nitrogen. Let's put all of this together by identifying the primary, secondary, and tertiary carbons, as well as the substitution of the alcohols and nitrogen on this molecule. This is the molecular structure of morphine, which I found on Google. Let's start high to low. How many quaternary carbons do we have on this molecule? We're looking for anywhere I can put my pencil down and get four lines coming out of it. For example, this right here has two, that's not quaternary. This one has three, not quaternary. We're looking for carbon with four bonds, which would be this one right here. And that's it. Moving down to tertiary, we're looking for a carbon with three bonds coming out of it. This carbon has three bonds coming out to carbon. That's tertiary for one, two, three. This one looks tertiary, but that's a bond to nitrogen, not carbon. Doesn't count. This one, same thing, has a bond to oxygen. Doesn't count. Same thing, bond to oxygen, same thing, and same thing. Looks like we have just three tertiary carbons. Let's move down to secondary carbon atoms. Now we have the ones that appear to be tertiary, but one of the bonds is to a non-carbon, which is a heteroatom, like oxygen or nitrogen. So we have one, two, three, four, five, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oops, that's not secondary because it's a bond to nitrogen. 10, 11. That's 11. Next, we move on to primary carbons, and we have, that's not a primary carbon because it's not bound to another carbon atom. This would be a primary carbon because it's bound to carbon and nitrogen. We have just one primary carbon. Now let's look at our alcohols. For the alcohols, we have this oxygen sitting on a secondary carbon, as is this oxygen. That gives us two secondary alcohols. And the amine, remember, it has its own classification. We're looking at the number of bonds coming out of the nitrogen atom. That would be one, two, three, for one tertiary amine.
Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for resources and information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, then I have a deal for you, a free copy of my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry. Use the link below or visit orgosecrets.com to grab your free copy. After downloading your free copy of my ebook, you'll begin receiving my exclusive email updates with cheat sheets, reaction guides, study tips, and so much more. You'll also be the first to know when I have a new video or live review coming up. If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up and share it with your organic chemistry friends and classmates. I will be uploading many videos over the course of the semester, so if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, do so right now to be sure that you don't miss out.